This tutorial will show you how to make a map using the Source SDK. Read the description, it's got a link to another video you have to watch before this one to totally understand it. Okay, let's go! In the Source SDK, there are three different things you need to understand. Blocks, entities, and triggers. Blocks you can make by clicking on the block tool here. It's used to make levels, so you drag out a block by holding down the mouse button, and when you're happy with where the block is, you press enter and it will make it in the level. To see your level so far, you click on the camera entity, which is the third one down. You then click on one of the 2D views so you can see that ball appear. That is where your camera is in the level. As you can see, it's currently inside the block. So to be able to see your level, move your mouse over the camera part of the screen and press Z. You can now move around your level and see what it looks like. If you're having trouble making blocks, you've probably got the selection tool selected and you're going, oh, and it's disappearing. So you've got to make sure the block tool is selected before you can make bits of your level. I'm going to make more of this level just so it looks a bit more pretty. To choose the texture, I click browse on the right hand side of the screen and type in the thing that I want the texture of. So there's a nice grass texture. And to make walls, you choose the block tool and you stretch it up on the bottom two, because these are the side views. So as you can see, changing it on the bottom view will change the size of the wall. And that's about it. You can now go and make your level. There, now as you can see, I have made the level. This is just done out of blocks. As you can see here, I have a slope. To make slopes, you just make a block and then you click on the clipping tool, which is this one here. And you can then drag it out, and the bit that's in white will be the bit that's left when you press enter. If you keep clicking on it, you can toggle which bits are left. So there, that's how you make slopes. And if you want to make steps or other more detailed things, you can change the detail of the grid by clicking these two buttons or by pressing the buttons next to P on your keyboard. 16 or 8 are good sizes for stairs. So here's a couple of stairs. That's all. But it doesn't really matter that much because this is a tutorial about everything, not just stairs. So there, stairs. Next, I'm going to add a person in the level so you can play it. To do this, you click on the entity tool. So this is the second of three things you need to learn about in the Source SDK. Once you've placed an entity in your level, it'll load up. It'll look like a person. Using the selection tool, you can double click on that and you can go down a massive list of things. And this goes everywhere from special effects to game options, physics objects, and weapons. If you want a weapon on the ground, you place a weapon on the ground. So if you want something in your level, it's in this list somewhere. I'm just going to place a person in the level, so just place another person. And that'll allow me to play the level. So I'll spawn where that person is in the level, but only if he's not touching anything. So just to make sure, I'm going to make him in the middle of an open area off the ground. And finally, I'm going to add a skybox. This is just the limitations of your level, because your map won't work unless you have this, as people have learnt the hard way. So here's a big block. Enter. It's all the way around the entire map. I now choose the skybox texture by typing in SKYBOX. It's the one at the bottom, Tools Skybox. To apply this to a block I've already made, it's this button on the left hand side. Apply current texture. Now this is done, I need to make it hollow, otherwise you're going to be stuck inside a big block called Skybox. So I press Ctrl and H together and I make it minus 32. So there, this is my level. To play it, you press this button or F9. Set VIS to fast, keep the other two to normal and don't run the game after compiling. Click OK. It might tell you to save the game when you press F9. If so, save it. You have to save and play your game regularly. If you don't do that, then you're likely to make some mistakes. It will take ages to fix the problem. So this will take a long time, probably 5 or 6 seconds. Once it's done, load up Counter-Strike Source or whichever game you're making it for, and it'll be in the maps list. Make sure there are no spaces in the map name or it won't work. Okay, you've played your level, but it's not very interesting. To fix it, I'm going to add some light into the level because light makes everything look better. Click on the Entity tool again, click somewhere in your level, it doesn't matter where for this one. I'm going to make it a light underscore environment. Click Apply, and now it doesn't matter where you place this in the level, I tend to place it above everything else, so it's in the sky so it's easy to find. And I'm going to point it at somewhere in the level, and this is the direction the light will come from. The light will come from the skybox, but it'll be in this sort of direction. So in this direction, there will be shadows here, and it just looks nicer. So now we've got lighting, your level will look more professional than some of the maps on the websites that you download maps from. But let's add objects, because that objects make things much more interesting. Click somewhere in the level and choose prop. If you want something static, like a tree, choose prop underscore static. If you want something that moves around like barrels, choose prop underscore physics. Once you're happy with your choice of what type of prop it is, click World Model and click Browse. You can then type in things like oil drum if you want an oil drum, or tree if you want tree. If it doesn't appear in your level and you've placed it in, then the chances are you've chosen the wrong type of entity. So instead of physics, try static, or instead of static, try physics, and it should appear. So there, in this map I've got lighting, objects, spawn points, and a map. That's all you need really to make a good level. But now it's time to add some bomb sites. To do this, I choose the block tool again. I choose the area of the map I want the bomb site to be. So I want it to be at the top of this area here. So I highlight this area. When people are inside this area, they'll be able to plant the bomb. So I press enter. As you can see, it looks like a bit of the map. To make it look different, I just choose the trigger texture because it's see-through and you can see that it's a bomb site if it's this texture. Now this is done, I select it and press Control and T. From here I can make it a door if I wanted, so this will be a door that you can open, but no, that would just be silly. I'm going to choose funk underscore bomb underscore target. Click Apply, and there we go. That's a bomb zone. To make an area of the map people can buy weapons in, it's exactly the same, only instead of funk underscore bomb underscore target, it is funk underscore buy zone. So I choose this, and this will turn into a buy zone, but I need to choose the team. So this will be a terrorist one. There, I have made a level. I'll just place some more spawn points in. Now to make this level playable, I'll add in some counter-terrorists. To make these entities counter-terrorists, I'm going to hold down Control so I can select more than one at once. Once they're all selected, I go up to Edit, down to Properties, and I change the entity name to counter-terrorist. I can save some more time by copying the buy zone for the terrorists, pressing Control C and Control V to paste it. So this is just a copy of the buy zone. I double click on it with the selection tool selected. I change the team number to counter terrorist and apply. There, this level will now work. But that's not good enough. Let's add in some ladders. To do this, I select the block tool, click browse on the texture menu, type in ladder. And I place it in the level where I want to be able to climb up. So this bit of the wall will do here. Make the block, click on the selection tool, and once the block is selected, I press Control T and choose funk underscore ladder and apply. People can now climb up the wall at this bit here. It doesn't look like a ladder. To do this, I add in another thing separately with the ladder texture. And so you'll see that ladder texture there, but you'll climb up this entity here, which is invisible. There's your level. For more help on water or glass windows, there are some links in the description and in the annotations of this video. I hope this helps you make maps.